Hello everyone, my name is Shanae Jones and this is KNKY, which stands for Know the New Kinky You. And I am a certified sex coach that is here to provide some glimpses into some of the issues that we as women have with orgasm. And one of the things that women need to really understand is that orgasm is not impossible, but it does take you getting to know and becoming very familiar with your body and how it works. Now, most women have some type of trouble with orgasm, and it can be up to 80% of women who struggle with trying to achieve it. Now, one of the things that we have to remember though is that an orgasm is something that comes in waves. The intensity of it, the type of feeling that it invokes in us can all really be different. And so whether it's mild to extreme, or we were talking earlier about female ejaculate, and you can kind of see that some women are able to squirt physically across the room and you feel like, oh my God, I can never do that. Well, that's not necessarily true. You just have to take the time to practice and get to learn your body. So one of the beauty of being a woman is that when men achieve orgasm, they go into a refractory state, which means that's after they come, they go soft. And it takes a little bit of time for that buildup to happen. But as women, we can achieve multiple orgasms. And being able to achieve multiple orgasms, we don't have that same refractory period where it has to end because we've come. No, it ends because we get tired of coming, basically. So when you are able to achieve that feeling, you'll be able to control how often it happens and improve the intensity and feelings behind the level of orgasm that you experience. So, one of the things that you should know, if you haven't heard me say this before, is that the clitoris is the only part of the human body that was designed solely for sexual pleasure. It means that all women have the capacity, the ability, and the right to come. We have it. It's ours. We should own that. So, in our diagram, so I have a diagram that I didn't bring right now, but in it, in a previous video, you'll see that when you're looking at the clit from the external view, all you see is this little teeny tiny piece of the head, but that is not all of the clitoris. What you have is a makeup internally of a organ that has about 8,000 nerve endings and is very, very sensitive. So what you have to remember is that when you become sexually aroused, your clit becomes engorged. It fills with blood, just like the way a penis does. It's basically a little penis. It's very, very sensitive. So when you're doing manual stimulation, you need to consider it not just the actual clit area, but also the whole vulva, your vaginal mound, your lips, your urethra, your vaginal openings. All of it can help with the stimulation, but you have to decide whether or not direct stimulation or indirect stimulation to the clitoris is more satisfying to you, because you need to practice with different techniques. So when you are attempting to masturbate, make sure that you are setting up the environment. So whether or not you need to have music or candles or be laying down, everything just needs to be complete, because again, orgasm for women especially is a physical, mental, and emotional thing. So you need to be positioned in a way to allow a physical release without forcing it. So you can't force it, you just have to kind of let it happen. So experiment with different techniques, make sure you're comfortable. Play with different patterns, pressures, and speeds. Also have patience and take your time, because this is not, again, it's more of a marathon than a sprint. So as you get to know your body more, you'll become more familiar with how to make these things happen in a more regular basis. So again, have patience with yourself. Don't put pressure on yourself as if this is something that is supposed to happen. I'm just going to make myself. There are women who are lucky enough to make that happen, but they're also very, very seasoned and very, very practiced, or very, very sensitive and lucky. So if you're not one of those women, just understand that it can take time and it can take patience. So some things to help, though, is that, again, when you're using manual stimulation with your fingers or toy, but you have to figure out whether or not you're applying direct or indirect pressure and stimulation, whether or not you're using the whole area versus just focusing on your clitoris. You may also need to stimulate the G-spot, which is to insert a toy or fingers into your vagina and feel along the ridges, feel along the urethral opening for about a 2-inch gland that has ridges, so you can feel it and it protrudes. Make sure that you have tension and breathe. So as you're breathing through it, your body kind of relaxed and you can kind of, you know, appreciate the moment. Also, you can moan, and when you arch your back, not in this way, not forward, but with your shoulders back and your arch up, you're positioning yourself to be in a better orgasmic state. And honestly, one of the best ways to kind of get to a real orgasm, and when you're not ready, is to fake one. Because when you start to go through the motions of breathing and moaning, and if you're in it, you can kind of absorb it and really have an orgasm. So there are techniques, and this is all a conversation, just say that there are techniques and ways to have an orgasm. So if this is something that you struggle with, we can have a conversation. I'm a certified sex coach and here to answer questions. I go over concerns, and working with me gets you a free 30-minute consultation. So feel free to reach out. This is Shanae Jones, and this is KNKY. I hope you have a great day.